The government is considering bringing forward $158 billion worth of personal tax cuts. It's among a number of likely budget measures so we can all help spend our way out of recession.
Seeing the flying kangaroo's wings clipped is deeply personal for Col Rayner.
It's an iconic Australian company.
His long career is nearing an end, but the pushback driver came to Canberra today in support of friends who are among thousands discarded by the national carrier.
A lot of proud people, hard-working people who work for this company.
The Transport Workers Union is launching legal action against Qantas's plan to outsource 2,500 jobs.
Tomorrow this could be any worker in Australia.
Unemployment will get worse and Labor is determined to pin that pain on the government.
Isn't this the worst possible time to cut the support that Australians need? Won't it make the Morrison recession longer and deeper?
Australians know that this government has showed up for them.
But as it prepares for an October budget, the Coalition knows it has to deliver a plan for recovery. The government is considering bringing forward the last two stages of its $158 billion in personal income tax cuts, slated to start in mid-2022 and mid-2024.
Tax cuts put more money into people's pockets, and more money into people's pockets means more spending, and more spending means more jobs.
But nothing will improve until the internal border walls come down. National Cabinet meets tomorrow, and the Prime Minister knows that Western Australia and Queensland will rebuff his call for an end to the impasse.
Australia was not meant to be closed. Australia was meant to be open, Mr Speaker.
So Scott Morrison is now seeking a better approach to medical emergencies and a plan to be open by Christmas.
2021 is going to be a better year than 2020, Mr Speaker.
Surely it can't possibly be worse. Chris Yulman, Nine News.